Well, a Toronto-based surgeon is getting recognized for his work with the Canadian Forces. Dr. Homer Tien is a director of trauma services at Toronto's Sunnybrook Hospital. He also played a pivotal role as a surgeon for the Canadian Forces in Afghanistan. He's been honored with a special research chair to continue his work to improve trauma treatment for soldiers and civilians. Neoko Carney has the story.
Trauma surgeon Dr. Homer Tien is a leader in his field, both in the hospital and on the battlefield. As a colonel in the Canadian Forces, he's provided life-saving care to Canadian and coalition troops for more than 20 years.
You got your medical start in the Canadian Forces. Tell me, why were you attracted to becoming a military trauma surgeon?
At the time, I thought it would be an interesting job. I was always interested in the military, but first and foremost, I think I was a little short on cash and it helped pay for medical school.
Dr. Tien has since treated patients in multiple war zones and has completed 5 tours of duty in Afghanistan as a surgeon in the Medical Multinational Unit Hospital in Kandahar.
When we took over, it was in a little plywood shack and there were 2 general surgeons. We operated out of 1 operating room. By the time I left, my last time I was in Afghanistan in November 2011, there was a large brick building with 3 state-of-the-art operating rooms, multiple CAT scanners, so it was a hospital like any other hospital in North America.
We are now standing in what is one of the best and the largest trauma centers in Canada. So tell me, how have your experiences in Afghanistan helped you here at Sunnybrook, where you're the medical director of trauma? I mean, the environment couldn't be more different.
I think it's a bit of both. What I've learned here has helped in Afghanistan and likewise here. So in Afghanistan, we see, for example, many more traumatic amputations. So dealing with that subset of patients, I have a little more experience with that from Afghanistan. But more importantly, how we transfuse patients and how we resuscitate patients. One of the lessons that we've learned in Afghanistan was that perhaps we should be giving more blood products. So we've taken this back here. In fact, we're conducting larger clinical trials to determine what's the best way to transfuse bleeding patients.
And that brings me to your latest accomplishment. You've been awarded the Frederick Banting Research Chair for Military Trauma Surgery. What do you hope to do with this?
Broadly, I think it's important to innovate new ways to care for injured soldiers and injured Canadian civilians as well. I'd like to foster more research in how to deal with bleeding trauma patients. And we already have great expertise here. And I think this, with this term chair, we can build on that expertise and conduct more life-saving research here.
Thank you very much, and congratulations on your latest accomplishment.
Thank you very much.
For Sun News Network, I'm Sneha Kulkarni from Sunnybrook Health Sciences.